Hi there! Did you ever consider adding new cameras to the field? Maybe sometimes one is just not enough. But adding cameras can be really challenging. You have to pull a whole new set of cable, or you have to hire the cable guy for a couple hundred bucks. What if I tell you, you can add the new cameras by using your existing Ethernet cable? Today in this video, I'm going to show you how to add up to 6 cameras by using your own existing cable. But before we jump to the video, I'd like for you to hit the like button. It could really help with the YouTube algorithm and make my life a whole lot easier. So let's get right onto it. If you want to add new cameras without pulling a whole new set of cable line, the first thing you have to take care of is the network port. You will have to expand your network port in the field. The simple solution is using the PoE switch. The switch can supply up to 4 network ports, but it needs power to run. So if there's a power source around the field, using the switch is just fine. However, if you don't have any power source around, in this case, all you need is the PoE power switch, aka the PoE pass-through switch. The difference between the two switches is the power switch can take power from the center and pass it through the cameras. So all you need to do is simply just add the PoE power switch and connect it to the new cameras in the field. It sounds really easy, right? So now, let's move on to the demonstration board and I'll show you how to install the whole system on your own. So here we are at the demonstration board. This is the PoE switch that I talked about. Now it's connected to both the NVR and a live camera. Let's see, my hands right here. This is live camera. So now all I need to do is to add the PoE power switch in the edge so we can add new cameras to the power switch. Let me hook up the power switch first. Now the PoE power switch has been hooked on the wall. If you look closer, the switch has rubber seal enclosure all around for waterproof so it can work in any harsh environment. The switch can be powered by another PoE switch, but only port 8 can take in the power from the PoE switch. The rest of the port will output the PoE power. And since we don't need to keep power in the switch, so the working temperature will be lower. That is one of the reasons why it can work in a hard environment. Now, let's disconnect the cable from the camera. And we are going to plug it in. Since this is all rubber, so the cable line is also waterproof. And we just have to squeeze it in and tighten it. Remember what I said, only port 8 can take in the power. See, the lights is on. Now I'm going to add another cable to a new camera. And don't forget our existing camera. I will add another line right here and connect it to our existing camera. Now the system has been set up. Let's see, the both cameras are working live. You see my hand right here? So one thing I didn't mention about is the power budget. The device that we're using is the PoE plus switch, which has the maximum output of 30 volts. If you want to add more cameras or high power devices, I would recommend you to watch another video about how to use the 90 volt PoE injector to increase the power budget. Now, thank you for watching. I'll see you next time.